Heed your humble
Champion's name became a rallying cry, a reminder that the mighty Templars could be defied. She had defended the mages against a brutal injustice, and many lived to tell the tale. The circles rose up and set the world on fire. More Templars arrived at Kirkwall to restore order, but we were already long gone. We vanished into the hills, and circumstance eventually forced us all to leave the Champion's side. Well, all of us except for Isabella. You still hear the stories, of course. With each telling, they grow, even if at the core remains the truth. A new legend had been born. So that's it. That's the whole story.
Then Meredith provoked the circle. She was to blame.
Or that damned idol was. Or Anders. Take your pick.
Even so, had the champion not been there,
it might never have even gone that far.
I see.
So how is hearing all this going to help? You've already lost all the circles. In fact, haven't the Templars rebelled as well? I thought you decided to abandon the Chantry to hunt the mages.
Not all of us desire war, Varric. Please. If you know where the champion is, you must tell me. She is a hero. A woman that the mages would listen to. Someone who was there at the beginning. The champion could stop this madness before it's too late. She may be the only one who can.
Is that what this is all about? In that case, I wish I could help you.
Just tell me one thing, then. Is the champion dead?
Though, I doubt that.
Then you are free to go, Varric. May the Maker watch over you during the dark times ahead of us.
Same to you, Seeker. Same to you.
So, did you...
Gone. Just like the Warden.
That is no coincidence.
So, do we proceed with the original plan, or keep looking?
It is in the Maker's hands now. We put our faith in him.
I'm not calling you a thief. Please don't steal from me. I'm not calling you a ghost. Stop haunting me. I love you so much. I'm gonna let you kill me.
And when you kiss me,